In simpler times, we relied on the valley's natural springs as our main source of water. But as the railroad brought more people out west, the demand for water outpaced supplies. Las Vegas soon developed its first robust water delivery system.
Throughout the early 1900s through the 1920s, you see the expansion of this water system. You see more redwood mains, you see more piping going through downtown Las Vegas, other water facilities being built here. And by late 1920s, the Las Vegas Land and Water Company had started to build other facilities, including pump stations, reservoirs, and other ways to help contain the water and also treat and pump the water with some pressure into town. So where we're standing right now, this is the Clark Street pump station, and it actually dates to about 1955.
So some of the early pipes that were used here in the valley were made from redwood versus other materials. Why was redwood used?
Redwood was cheap. Redwood was inexpensive. It was easy to obtain from the west coast of the United States and get it here to Las Vegas. It was also very difficult to maintain, constant leaks. So to improve the system, make sure there was less water loss, they started putting in some metal piping early on.
The current construction methods differed, you know, back in the 50s. And they used a lot thinner steel can and then wrapped it with these high strength wires to make up for the pressure strength of the pipeline. The only drawback on them, the thin can didn't allow for much corrosion resistance or corrosion allowance. So once the pipeline started to corrode, eventually it led to the leaks. So this is a newer, our current standard of pipeline that we install. It's much bigger than the smaller 24 inch, but what differs, we install a lot thicker steel can on our steel pipelines without the bar wrapping. So that has the same strength, pressure requirements, but it has a lot more corrosion allowance on the pipelines.
It takes a lot of energy to move millions of gallons of water through those pipelines. Pumping stations today have enough force to push heavy water uphill for miles to reservoirs, the last stop drinking water makes before it flows through your tap.
Behind us, there are six pumps that are 4,000 gallons per minute each. They're 350 horsepower, and they pump the water up to an elevation about 100 feet higher than here to a reservoir about 3 miles away. Behind us, there are four more pumps that pump to a higher elevation. So we call this a two-zone lift pumping station. So those pumps are 1,000 gallons per minute each, and they're 250 horsepower, and they pump to a reservoir about 4 miles from here. So collectively, we run all 10 of these pumps to move that 30 million gallons of well water up to the other reservoirs north and west of us.
So what kind of technology do we use now that either extends the lives of the pumps or makes water delivery more efficient?
One of the most efficient things we do is just the sheer capacity of the pumping station. So we want to pump only at night when the power costs are cheaper. From a mechanical point of view, there is a lot of improvements in material design, such as using stainless steel shafts on the pumps and motors. They coat the casings with this Belzona coating, and it's basically like it makes it more slippery for the water to move through the pump faster. It prevents corrosion and it reduces friction, and anytime you can reduce friction you're reducing the power cost that it's going to take to move that water.
Technology allows Janelle's team to monitor every drop of water in the system in real time. Operators can detect the smallest change in water levels and water pressure. Similar technology helps Ryan and his team see what's happening in pipelines buried beneath our busy city streets. They can determine whether leaks or other issues warrant immediate attention before they literally dig into the problem.
We use the technology to prioritize which pipelines we get into, because shutting them down is a huge ordeal. All the assessments we've done over the years, typically the pipelines will go farther than 50 years. With our new technology, leak detection, some of that permanent leak detection monitoring, we can extend the life of those pipelines by tens of years. And with the application of corrosion control, we're up into the hundreds.
And that kind of ingenuity and service is possible today due to better planning, more efficient equipment, and advanced technologies. all of which make it possible to have one of the most reliable water systems in the country.